In this module, we're going to talk about some of the new features that we have in Azure SQL Database. There's been some changes as we progress through the versions, and if you'll notice in the portal now, there's actually, you'll see V12. And when you see V12 noted in the Azure portal, that's our newest, our latest version of the Azure SQL Database. It very much is kind of drawing on the same things that we have in the on-premises version of SQL Server. So in the past, what we had was kind of a subset of what's there, because obviously you can't manage the underlying server that's hosting this. You're just managing more the database level and how many DTUs or the performance level you need your SQL Server to be at. But there's been a lot of call out for things like encryption, especially around security and encryption technologies. How can we enable those in Azure because of regulatory requirements or just general, I need to encrypt my database or it already is encrypted? How are we going to handle those features as we move into this cloud model? So I'm going to draw out a little bit here, but basically if you looked at what we have in the cloud, so if we have our database sitting up here and we have an application maybe that's over here that's going to use some of this application data. So by default, with our existing model, and this is an Azure SQL, we would actually have just our data being stored here in a series of tables. The application will be communicating through this. And because this is a PaaS model, if you think about the Azure SQL database, it's not in a VNet. There's no VNet support for that. So there's a public endpoint exposing this Azure SQL database to the internet, which and our app is able to actually exercise across there. Now, this was encrypted, obviously. So this little tunnel here had SSL on it. So anything going over the internet, whether it was credentials or logging into the database or moving data around, was encrypted in transit, right? But we didn't have anything here to encrypt how this thing's actually being stored on disk over here, right? So underneath this is actually blob storage, right, that we're actually writing these blocks to. So underneath this Azure SQL database, the problem was people would come along and say, I want this thing to be encrypted. How can we kind of make sure that these can't be viewed if somebody just arbitrarily gets into our database there? So a couple different things have kind of evolved out of that. The first one was TDE. So TDE is a transparent data encryption. And I'll show you where these are turned on inside the portal, but TDE is a server-side technology. And so basically inside of it, your Azure SQL database that's up in your portal, you would enable this feature, you would turn it on, and then Azure will make sure that at rest, it will basically encrypt your data that's sitting on that disk. So to the application, again, it's transparent. So he's accessing over SSL, continues to access over SSL, nothing changes for him. If somebody were able to get a copy of that database or be able to look at that database to be able to log in, they would see garbage, right? Because it's transparently encrypted up there if somebody was able to get to that. We also had another encryption technology that came along called Always Encrypted. Now, Always Encrypted is a little bit different animal. Again, this is in our on-premises product and allows you to, at a column or a table level, you can actually specify that I want to make sure this stuff is encrypted the entire way through the pipeline. And so in that case, we're basically talking more about, like on my little diagram here, this is the client side, right, because this is our app. This guy would actually be using something like, let's say, Key Vault. And I'll just put KV here, but this is the Azure Key Vault. The Key Vault, we talked about in other modules, but basically this is able to store secrets. So inside of here, we can do an HSM module to actually store keys, right? So think of this as like passwords or like the actual secrets to your application. So this client would actually be enabled to use the Key Vault to be able to talk to this app. So in that model, if you didn't have access to the Key Vault, you can't look at anything. The entire thing is encrypted. So anytime this data is being moved across here, obviously there's SSL on, but we also have this other layer of encryption turned on now because we're using Key Vault. So the data that's being passed between here, even if the SSL was not there, you still couldn't read it. If you went up and queried this table directly without accessing the key from the Key Vault, you wouldn't be able to see anything. You would see a bunch of garbled, looks like hashes and those kind of things up there. And so that's the key feature for Always Encrypted when we turn that on. Now that's not a feature, obviously, because it's a client-side piece. That's not something you turn on inside the portal. That's something that you would turn on inside your application. And so there's some guidance around how to enable that, but it's important to understand the difference between what we have on the server side versus what you would do on the client side to kind of give you the best of these features. Now, these are only in V12. We mentioned V12 before, but these are only features for there. The other feature we have is it's called Stretch Database. And really what that allows you to do is say, hey, I have, and let me go ahead and clear my screen here. We'll do one from scratch here. So in this case, we have our on-prem here. And let's say this is Azure. We're able to take a database that we have here, and let's say it's got, this is table one, this is table two, and this is table three. We can actually put table four here. So in this case, we would actually have, obviously there's a database that's housing this table, but what would happen is in our actual configuration here, we can change it such that it'll stretch across into the cloud. So we can actually take an on-premise database that's already running, has all this stuff configured, as long as it's on the latest version of SQL Server to support this, we can then actually start to stretch the tables and all the data storage for that up into Azure. So huge feature for someone that wants to operate in kind of a hybrid model, or they're just getting, you know, started with the cloud. This is a great model for you to kind of start stretching into the cloud, and maybe even for archive tables. So I see that a lot with businesses as well, where they say, I have some data, maybe it's log data or some things that I really don't care so much about. I don't want to pay for that storage on-prem. How about I just stretch that table up to Azure? So as data is being written to the app, it's automatically just being written up into the Azure SQL database instance. And so the other one is full text search. So another feature that we've had for quite some time in the on-premises client or version of SQL Server is full text search. And really, that allows you to do catalogs. So basically, if you want to do fuzzy searches over different keywords inside your data in your database, instead of having to build indexes and go through those kind of things, we can actually use the full-text search engine, which will basically span across those things. Now, it is kind of locked to column. So basically, you would lock a column and say, I want to do a fuzzy search on this client, this column. But then you could do all kind of, you know, if you're used to T-SQL where you do like statements with some of the control characters in SQL, T-SQL, you wouldn't have to use those. Like you could just use your full text catalog and do fuzzy search, like starts with C-A-T or something like that. So another benefit to that. But really the idea here that we're doing with SQL Server is to be able to enable most of the things that we're doing on premises up in Azure. Now, there is still some that won't probably ever be there, right? So we're talking about server-level things like backups, things that would affect the actual SQL Server to a point that you would need to know the infrastructure underneath it. And so in those cases, the guidance is if we need to get that low level into things, the pieces that expose it are DMVs. So our management views inside Azure or inside SQL Server allow us to basically get that kind of telemetry if we need to get performance counters. I see this a lot where people are doing profiling. Because we don't have a SQL profiler, you can't just take the on-premises version of SQL Profiler and attach it to Azure. Because it would need some level of access to the underlying server, which it wouldn't have in this case. And so in that model, basically, you can use the DMVs to kind of harness and pull some of those performance metrics back that you're looking for. So the guidance I give there is really, if you're looking for something and you can't find it in SQL Server, look into DMVs. There's really been a whole push to kind of move things over to DMV so it's flexible, right? We can run the DMVs on-prem, but we can also run them up in Azure. And that's really the model to think about as you're going forward. But really some great strides from the team. I'll pop over to the portal just for a second to show you what that looks like in real form. So when you're provisioning a SQL database, I have one provisioned here right now, and this is under the premium SKU. But when you go into it, again, we mentioned a lot of features here that we have to enable. I mentioned the client-side technology you'll do in your code, but some of the other ones you can see right here, we have our features, and right there is TDE, Transparent Data Encryption. So in this case, we would basically just come in, turn the switch on, hit save, and that's all we need to do to enable Transparent Data Encryption. We have other features in there for thread detection and dynamic data masking I didn't mention, but wholesale features that are coming along there. So check it out when you're provisioning your Azure SQL databases. And that concludes this module.